Hey everybody and welcome back to another Darkfall video. Today I want to share with you the updated version for the shader library add-on, version 1.2, and you can see the example here. So for those of you who followed this channel for a while, you might have already seen a tutorial that I did called How to Create a Stylized Potion. So yeah, 2 years ago I created this how to create a potion. It was like 18 minutes long and it's far too long, so let's just have a look at this. Hey and welcome back to another dark. Turn that off. So yeah, this video, I think for the first 8 minutes we're modeling a bottle, which is far too long. Let's see. Yeah, 8 minutes to create the bottle, and then for the rest of the video we create the material for the potion shader. So by the end of it we should have a potion material like this. So I wanted to add this material to the shader library. So the first thing we need to do is go ahead and download version 1.2 of the shader library, and that can be done by going to our blog. There'll be a link in the description which will take you here. So once you've downloaded the add-on, make sure you install it by going to Preferences, Add-ons, and then Install it. And just make sure that you have version 1.2, and then we can enable that. So yeah, I'm not going to spend 8 minutes creating a bottle. It's fairly simple and there's hundreds of different, maybe thousands of different types of bottles, I don't know. So go ahead and create yourself a bottle, or if you want to use the file that I'm using, go ahead and download it as well. So I'm just going to go ahead and open this up. So this is the demo file I'm going to be using. It's just a few simple bottles which they're poorly modeled. I would suggest creating your own because I didn't really spend too much time creating these. But if you want to use them, then there'll be a link in the description. Go ahead and use them. So I'm going to change this to the rendered view. So I've already added a glass shader to these bottles. If I go to the materials, you'll see it's just a very basic glass material. So then all we need to do is select the object that we want to add the shader to. So I'm going to select this liquid in the center here. Press N to bring up the side panel and go to the shader library. Then if we go to stylized and choose stylized potion, we get this pop-up menu here. So there's only a few options to choose. First, we can select the colors that we want to use, and then also the start and end frame, since this material is animated. So I'm going to leave these at default and hit OK. And then we get this material here. Then if I scrub through the timeline, you'll notice the preview here will start to change so that it will be animated. These swirls will begin to disperse. Then let's go ahead and add the other materials. So I'm going to select this liquid, change this color to something like green, change the darker color to another green, hit OK, and there we go. And again, we could do this for all the materials that we want. We could also change the two colors. They don't have to be the same color. Get something really crazy looking. Get this weird potion, I don't know. But I mean, you could take this further and build upon these nodes and add to it and make it look a lot better, or change the colors, do what you want. I'm going to change this now to blue because I think red, green and blue are maybe the standard. So there we go, that's the stylized potion. Again, you could take this further, you could build upon this, go into the nodes and add to it, change it. You can get variations of it by adding maybe an emission shader and make it glow. And again, this is all up to you depending on what kind of potion you want to create. But I'm probably going to add some more lights and maybe add some fancy camera animation and then render it all out. And yeah, that'll be the example you see at the beginning. So yeah, hopefully you find this addition helpful. If you do, be sure to give this video a like. As always, thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.